new page and I have something in mind. So let's see. Okay, first, and we do need a couple because we're gonna do, well, not quite a waterfall, but similar. So, and I even don't know how much, so I'm first gonna cut two pages. I think that would be enough. So I'm gonna cut two pages that has the same size as this one. And let me first make a flippity flop. I did it completely wrong because I wanted to have it this way. This way I want it. But then I need, yeah, I do. I wanna have it this way. Oh my gosh. Oh, I'm so sorry. Okay, I made a mistake. Sorry guys. I need my page this direction. And then of course a flippity flop. And I already made a flippity flop, so that's okay. Alright, so I am gonna make first the largest one. Just stay away 1/4 or 1/8 away from this. Then you are safe and sound. Alright, so now I'm gonna make another one. Same size. And I am gonna cut now again two pieces that are the same size. So guys, that first cut was not needed, but alright, let's make a flippity flop. And then just make this 1 inch shorter. Let's see, that's an 8. So then let's cut this a 7. Okay. This a 7. Alright, so we have another one. Let's make a flippity flop. And then let's cut this a 6. Can make with this one another flippity flop, and I bet that this is not a 5. Almost. Let's make it a 4. Means that I do need to make a 5 also. So I'm just gonna grab another piece, make this the same size, make a flippity flop, and then cut this at the 5. Alright, I think that this is short enough, and I think that we do have more than enough. Yeah, that's nice. Alright, now, you know, I like to have flippable pages. So if I put this to the left, I want this to be already here. So I am gonna start with the smallest one. So I'm going to end with the large one. Alright, that means that I need to put this on the back And then I'm gonna start with a small one. Okay, so I'm gonna put some tape on here. For me, it's easier to turn this. Okay, I'm grabbing my next one. It's going to be right here. On top. And the next one. Oh, this is going to be fun. And the next one. Oh my gosh. Is this a good idea? I have no clue, guys. I have no clue. Just let's try this out. And then the last one. The last one. Here we go. Oh my gosh. Oh, and it's on the same size as this one. I had no idea. Can it hold the hinge? Oh my gosh. Diane, that was not that smart of you. Maybe you could better do this on another page. Okay. Well, now it's on. And I'm not going to tear it off. So, fingers crossed for that. That this hinge will hold this. Oh, yes, it will be. Just gonna make a nice and thick white spine hinge. Alright, so the meaning is if you flip this page to the left, that you will see our waterfall on this side. That it was the meaning. Maybe I even can put this on here. That's cool. Yeah, with some golden touch away around. Love that. And then go further with all the other pages. Yeah, I love that. So yeah, and then on here I definitely like to make a pocket, but I don't want to be the pocket wider than this, so I'm just gonna make a mark. No further than here. So I want to make a pocket right here. Just a small one, so yeah, stay tuned. Okay, let's do this. Okay, let's see what kind of pocket do we want. Do we have some leftovers? Oh, this is a nice one. It's too high, but we can make that. So first we are going to make two flippity flops. Fold one piece, make it to where I made that mark. I'm just gonna stay on the inside, make a mark, and score and cut. Size. I used a smaller tape for my small ribbons. Here we go. And I'm just gonna cut a good amount of a triangle so nothing will interfere, nothing will bump. So like you can see now, nothing will bump in the way. How deep do we like this pocket? Okay. How deep is this? I think we're just gonna make it a 3. Then we still have a nice amount of size to put something nice on this pocket. Yeah, that's a nice size. All right, so maybe we can decorate this first, this pocket. Yeah, why not? You know me, I always gonna check out what I have. Blue one. What do we have? Light one. Otherwise I still have these left. Okay, yeah. Now I just go for, well, this one is a nice one to for a pocket. No, I just always like I'm addicted. I'm just gonna use what I have before I'm gonna cut in a larger piece. I am so strange. I know. I confess. But it's so cool to just use what you have. Oh, this is not. Okay. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut a half inch of this. So we're gonna split this pocket. Start with the top one. Go. And then we just can glue the bottom. Here we go, and now we're gonna decide what we want in between. Ooh, this one is nice. Let's do this. There we we go. And for this one, I also gonna do is this not straight? No, it's not. Oh, it's definitely not. It's definitely not. Let's see if this is better. I know it's not completely straight, but now at least I have my edge everywhere. Alright, so yeah, we're gonna do a a ribbon or something. Definitely gonna use some stamps if I can grab it. And we are gonna do some stamps as decoration. Smooch the edges always. Decide which one you want to see on top. And then this, oh yes, that's nice. So I don't need a ribbon, but maybe it is a nice pop up. Yeah, the blue is so nice bright. Here we go, let's put some ribbon on. This is my way on doing some ribbon. Just gonna put some double-sided tape. There you go. Here we go, and then just glue it on. Oh yes, here we go. And then this. Chica is really sleepy today. Well, soon we are gonna walk outside. I'm almost finished. Is that nice or is that nice? Super cool. Alright, put the pocket on. We do have this, wait just a sec. Yeah, there is a thing that I just like to do. So I'm first gonna peel off the bottom. If I do a pocket with a hinge at the bottom, then I like to put some tape at the bottom. Otherwise it's gonna be sticky. And I don't like it to be sticky. All can peel off this. Here we go. Yeah, yeah, yeah. There you go. Yep, let's find a nice background. I think it's time again to do a nice background with. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, I hear that my hubby is already at home. Oh my gosh, it's not time just yet. It's no time. Well, it's almost time. Anyways, I'm gonna do this patchwork for the background, and that will be my last thing. So I'm gonna add a double-sided tape on here, and then put that in the background, and then the rest we're gonna do together. All right. See you soon. All right, and here we have my busy background. Maybe it's too busy, I don't know, but I'm just gonna leave it for now. Because you don't see it. You don't see it if you put a nice thing inside. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I still love it. Alright, so that's my pocket. And now I need to cook my dinner. And I will see you next time. Alright, what shall we do on here? Maybe a nice frame? Something like that? We'll see, but this I like. Yep, with this, with the ears coming out, I really like this. Dream big. Yes, cool. Okay, I could not help myself. I just want to have this page done. So what I did was I cut a few strips with this blue one. This blue ornament page, all are half inch, and I just made these two as long as my page is, and then I'm gonna start with the first one on my left, nicely along the pocket. And then the other one on the other side, stay away a bit from the fold line. There we go. Then I'm gonna grab my next one. And this one is going to be cut same size. And I like to make a mark in the middle. So I'm gonna cut that, and I'm gonna cut from mark till corner. Don't forget to smooch. And then this fits nice. I just asked my hubby why he is that early at home, and he told me, well, Holland needs to play soccer. It's the world championship time of soccer. We both don't like soccer. Forgive me for those who are, can't love every sport, of course. So in the meantime, in just, well, at least 15 minutes, it's after 4 o'clock, and then it will be empty on the streets. There will be just a few, so I still need to go to the post office. So I will go after 4 o'clock because then there will be no much. Of course, there will be people on the street because there are more people like me and my hubby that does not like soccer. Alright, so that's my frame. I like it. And now I'm just going to find something nice to put in. Let's see. Shall we do this one? Wow, then we have quite a lot. I like it. Alright, then I need to have a nice image around. I also gonna do that with just leftover pieces, of course. Just with some leftover pieces. I think I'm just gonna use this one. I also can use the gold, like I did with this one, but I think that's too much gold. Don't you think? I'm just gonna add this in here. Alright, so I'm just gonna fill up this. Can I cut two? Yes, I can. Oh, I even can fill it up completely. See that? That's cool. I just can. Does not need, but I think this looks nice. Yep, so I'm gonna do that. Just gonna start with the first one. And don't forget to smooch the edges. I'm gonna try to do the, to have the pattern's nice, so I'm just gonna start with this one. Yep, let's go start with this one. And now I'm just going to try, as you can see, this fits nice, so I just have to cut this one down. Pretty much. Here we go. Yeah, I'm just gonna glue this down. If you have a nice picture, by the way, then of course you can skip this part because this is a nice photo frame, but I'm just gonna use this. And you always can over glue your photo, of course, if you get this album. Alright, yay, cool. See, and now this page fits perfect. See that? So nothing is interfering anything. Exactly what I wanted. Now it's time to cook dinner. Okay guys, so I must confess first before I start decorating this. I must confess that I think this was too busy for the patchwork, so I changed it in this beige color. I think this looks so much better. So I apologize because I must confess. Oh, I need to sneeze. So I must confess that this sometimes it looks good, sometimes it doesn't, and I thought I needed to change this. So that is what I did. So now we're continuing, and I only had one sheet left, and I already started a little bit with what I have left. So this was my last full sheet, so I wanted to start with a wet one on here. And the easiest part with this size album is that the A4, you can so easily use it. So these are not having any cute edges, just simple. So it's just a nice photo frame. Now I first go and see what I want on these sides. I do have this left, but let me first do a full one because these are shorter. Okay, and then I can see what I have left, and I still am on my, how much, this is my second set, yeah. So we still have 3 sets, so. Gosh, how many papers do we have? So many. I love that. So yeah, I don't have to worry that I haven't enough or something. And maybe I even can do it with 4 sets. I have no clue, but I just was not sure of myself. And I just wanted to add already just 5 sets. So nobody has any scare of not having enough papers. See, that looks cool, doesn't it? Right, now let's see what we can do on the last 2 pages, because they are big, and of course we are not going to make it, but that's okay because I still have a few pieces left, maybe for little tuck spots. This is still left. I can make a nice tuck spot with, and then this, maybe I even can make a small tuck spot on the big ones with this one. See, that fits marvelous for a nice tuck spot. And then the last one. All right, so let's go to, because I have everything is gone. My 2 sets. Look what I have left, guys. Is that marvelous or what? I even can put these 2 in the same tray because it's that little. It is that little that I have left. So yay, love that. So I used it almost all. Yeah, and of course I still have my basket. Okay, so I'll go now to my 3rd set. There we go. Can you imagine how many of these you have? You also can use these, of course, for leftovers. Not leftovers, but you can. I'm going to show you. You can cut these also out. This you can cut out, and this you can cut out. But this above, you can use that. You can, and I will, because I don't need 5 of these cut out sheets. But we have them. We have them. All right, so let's see. The papers that I now want to use is, of course, the ones with the cards. Because my second set, I used I cut all these out and I did not use the bag. Well, this one is maybe too busy, but I'm just gonna leave it out. This one is gorgeous for the end. Not for the end, but for the back of this page. And this page, I already see why I put some papers on the back of those cards. No. And then maybe you are going to know what I'm saying, because this is marvelous, but busy and not always good to use. This is perfect, but not always good to use. Same with this one, but oh my gosh, I love it. Not even for strips, also for backgrounds. All right, so I'm definitely gonna start with these, if it fits, of course. And this, I think, would be marvelous on this piece. Oh yes, I'm definitely gonna do that first before I change my mind. I just love this page. Just a simple back page, nice and solid, so it will save all my other pages. All right, so I don't want to ruin any image, so I'm just going to cut off on both sides a bit. There we go. Look at this. Oh yes, smudge the edges and it's ready to go. On, I'm not gonna do anything on the back because I think this page is already carrying so much. Sorry guys. Oh well, I think it will turn out wonderful. That is a nice last page. All right, so continuing all the left pieces. Okay, now I definitely want to go back with the blue, and then this comes by. So I'm gonna use it. And you don't need to decorate these if you don't want to. You also can leave them plain and put your photos on, of course. That's totally up to you what you like to do with that. Leaving pages plain, but for those who are going to make it as a photo album for maybe your baby photos or something, or your child pictures, or even your grown-up pictures, I can imagine that you maybe like to put right away your photos on. But the meaning is that we are going to put something on. All right, now I'm just gonna see what I want for the last page, because the last page is big. Big, 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 big. And these I already cut in a nice size. I also can use the red one back again. Shall we use another color? I also can use this as a little pocket. Let's use this one. Now this is going to be a tuck spot pocket. So I'm not gonna make, well we can do just a pocket because it's a nice big one. Oh, let's just do that. So we have something left. Here it is. I definitely want to use the full size of this. So I'm just gonna all right. I don't need this completely to cut down. Okay, let's make a pocket. Easy way. Is there a difficult way? No, I don't think so. Score, half inch. Score, half inch. I'm just gonna fold this. And I'm just gonna use the paper that I have, so you don't need to know any measurements because you are going to use your own leftover piece. You are, aren't you? Yes, you are. You are. There we go. Make a mark. It's a fat page, guys. Oh my gosh, it's so fat. I love it. There we go. That's the page. Guys, it's evening again and my neighbor's dog is again annoying me. Oh, it just don't stop. There we go. Only need a little adjustment. Perfect. There we go. Just perfect. So again, what I like to do is I'm just going to start at the bottom. I hope I am a frame. Burnish it down. Nice pockets. All right. What shall we do for the background? Still have. I think I am gonna do a. This one I am gonna make a little tuck spot. That means that I only have to make a pocket with my design paper. That means that you're only gonna glue down three sides. That's it. That's your little tuck spot. There we go. Maybe I can use this, but then I need something else. Just use what you have. Use what you have. And then she was quiet. What day is it today? It's Tuesday. There you go. And then this one. Just the fraction that I want is short, just a tiny little bit so it fits in between. I hate overlapping papers because then you get more bulk. Ah, we don't want that. Okay. I'm gonna use the red one. This fits perfect in between. Now you would say that this is a patchwork page, but we all know that this is also a tuck spot. So we are going to use it. I think this one. I'm gonna put this down. Paper, of course, because I like that better. It's not necessary, but I just like that better. Alright, and then just put this in here as a little tuck spot. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Alright, now here we have something for the background. Let's see. I think we can use this for the background because we use it also on here. Is it too much? Maybe it's too much. Maybe it's too much and the background is... tag we can't use. Oh, we also have this one, of course. Let's think. I also can use it for this. It's a really nice plain one, so I think I'm gonna use it for plain and quiet. Love it. Of course, with the smoochy edges. Here we go. And then I still need to find something for the back. That's okay, because we still need to find something for the left pages. they are not all done. Okay, now I still have this left, but then I also have to split this, so I'm just wondering if that's a good idea. Let's see, so this is nice, plain and solid. This is ready, but I also need these two. Maybe it's too much with these. Okay, let's see what paper. Can we use this? I do like it. So let's see. Let me first cut this and then I'm gonna see where I'm gonna use it for, because maybe it's a good idea for the back. So we do a little color in here. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna use this, but first I'm gonna cut a 3/4. I'm gonna add a little color in it. Then a 1/2 inch of this one. Oh, wait just a second, because I have, wait. I see that I have no, that's too much. No, I am 1/2 inch. Sorry guys, I thought I saw something that I could use, but that was a terrible idea. That's way too busy. That's no good. Let's just give this a little wet pink color. It's not pink, it's not wet, but all right, and then this can go a little deeper. Forgot. This needs to fit in the pocket. There you go. Then we can use this big one. Oh yes, I'm just going and going and going. You see how easy this all goes? Oh, I just love these papers. Love it, and not only because they are mine. No. A little bit also, of course. No, I'm just kidding. They are just so easy to work with. Love it. go, nice booklet. I think it also fits like this. You also can do this. See, that just fits. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That is possible. And you still can add something. Okay. Alright, so how far are we? Looking amazing. Looking fabulous. Not only these two. I think these fits nice on here. Don't cut too many papers if you still have the correct size. Okay, now I believe that I only have one piece left. So this is ready. This we still need to do. Ready, ready, ready. Okay, one piece. Let's see. A patchwork? Can be. It can be. Why not? Let's go crazy. Why not? Okay, let's give it a try. Let me give it a try. Why go easy when it also can go difficult? Alright, so I'm just gonna use a thin piece of paper. Let's see. This direction. Okay, I'm gonna play. Playtime. And then we're gonna see how I end up. I'm gonna play with this also. I'm just gonna split this in two. Little pieces. I need to know how far this gets. So I'm just going to make a little mark. Got this can overlapping a little bit. Alright, so they all need this size. Light ones. how far I am. And then she was quiet. Sorry, guys. I'm focused. Deep focused. Oh, these are too short. Oh, damn you. That's not good. That's not good. Let's see if I can do something with this. All right, give me something that fits. I actually want to do a wet color. Nope. Here is a blue one. That fits. Let's do the blue one. Let's do the blue one. Almost do not fit, but we can manage that. So we can manage because this one we still need, and I just can cheat just a little bit. Now, I always say you can hate this or you can love it, but when I now do a nice image, see which one. Which one? For example. Oh, we have a big one. I just used a. We have quite a lot. Oh, this one is cute. All right, which one? Oh, I'm terrible in making decisions. I am terrible. I think I like this one. Just make it nice. Oh, and I also need to cut it down. Just, oh my gosh, I'm too quick. Wait just a second. I'm going way too quick. I still need to cut this down a little bit. Just a little tiny bit. I just always like to go all the way around. Small little edge. And then it fits. Yes, cool. Smudge the edges. And actually, I do like one on this side. So cute. These are so cute. Why are these so cute? It's a bigger one. Choices. We have too much choices. Help me. Help me choose. Yeah, I wish I could do this off camera, guys. I wish I did this off camera so you don't have to wait that long. I am so sorry. Why are her videos always so long? I have no clue. Okay, guys. Here we are. I'm gonna put this. So you still have a little space for a nice small picture if you want. Here we go. Okay, as I say, you can love it, you can hate it, but this is also a nice way to use your leftovers. Yes, okay, and of course you can put little images here and there if you like. I will keep them plain for now because I think it's busy enough. This definitely wants something, but I'm not gonna. Nope. I'm gonna do that later. But I think it's cute. What do you think? Do you like this book? It's a book. Look how fat this is. Oh my gosh. I love it. But if you open this up, see, then this is the first thing that you see. See, this is the first thing that you see because this is going to be that direction. So first you have a pocket. And then you will see right here. And you go through these waterfalls. Little tuck spot. Pocket. And that's that. And then you go to the next page. Yay! That was the idea. All right, guys. Another tunnel is ready. How cool is that? So, this is really fat. This is a really big, fat page. I promise that the next one definitely needs a little space. It's so cool. It's so cool. Alright, cool. See you next. Next! What's next?